So, how do you define the organism or the individual organism? It's a different type of living entity or a distinct living entity which possess all those features which makes it separate from the other organisms or other individual species is called as the individual. And we need to remember individuals of the same type are supposed to interbreed. That means when we say organism, we're talking about a particular organism or an individual of a particular species. And then these individuals join to form population. So how do you define population? It's a group of similar individuals in a particular geographical area at a particular time. And then the next thing is that these individuals interact with each other in the population. Remember, there are types of population also, like local population in a particular area. Then a big area is there. It may have patches of population also. And then we all know in population also, individual develop certain features which could distinguish them from the other. It could be the features which are because of the long-term variation. Some could be because of the long-term adaptation. Some could be because of the short-term adaptation. So we'll be discussing these things in the notes as we proceed with this chapter. Then in the same manner, there is something called as community. Community is the whole populations of different species. That means when we say plants, even microorganism, animals, when they interact with each other and interact with the environment, we study it under the group called as community. Then we have the ecosystem where individuals interact even with the environment. So in communities, we study interaction between living organisms, different populations, and in ecosystem, we study the interaction of these populations along with the population's interaction with the environment also. Then landscape is a unit of land which is distinguishable from the other landscapes because of a particular type of ecosystem available there. And then we have biomes. Biome is a large region or large land which is supposed to have a specific type of climatic zone, and then there will be some major plants which are distinguishable there, and similar type of associated animals will be there. Like we all know desert. NCERT also mentioned biome word, and it gives you the name like desert. Then there is tropical rainforest, then grassland. So these things are called as biomes. And then we have the biosphere. Biosphere is a biological entity which is the inhabitable part of the hydrosphere, lithosphere, and atmosphere. Hydrosphere is the water bodies, then lithosphere is the soil or rock, and then we have the atmosphere, that is the air. So in these areas, there are areas where you will find living organisms are available. That all is together called as biosphere. Now the next term to understand is the environment. Environment is the sum total of all biotic and abiotic factors or conditions that surround and influence the organism. So environment is something which is supposed to influence the life of the organism every second. It could be because of the living things, or it could be because of the non-living things which surrounds the organism. So these are basically the resources available to the individual, and then the regulatory factors. We all know what are resources, food and all, and regulatory factors could be temperature, availability of light, availability of water, etc. We'll be learning in detail all these things in the class. So there is a term called as microhabitat. We need to understand then microclimate and climate and weather. In geography also, in the junior classes, you have learned what is weather and climate. We all know weather is a short-term property of environment, and then the weather climate is supposed to be a long-term property. Then when we say weather changes a lot from place to place, but climate is something which remains same for a large area of the land. Then weather is supposed to change with time to time. Climate is something which remains same for a long period of time. That's why we don't say weather change, we say climate change going on. So weather changes oftenly, and then there is a repetition also. Climate remains same for a long duration of time. Like we say, autumn has come. in the same manner we can say spring is coming, or the rain season or the monsoon is coming. So we all know that the weather is supposed to change. Weather changes with the change in the atmospheric factors also, but climate is something which is not changed because too much change because of the factors, and weather change have little impact. Weather change has a little impact on flora and fauna, but yes, climate change has a major effect on, it may even lead to the extinction of organism. In the same manner, there is microclimate also. Like for example, we all know that micro means smaller size. So it is possible that there could be an area where lots of vegetation is there, because of which a different type of small area climate variation is available in a big area. So that is called as a microclimate. Like for example, in the crop field, we have root systems of so many roots, root systems of the plants. So around the root, there will be a different type of availability of gases and moisture, and a different type of composition of the soil is possible around the roots. So that area could be called as a microclimate. Or maybe in some part of city, a lot of rain takes place in a particular time, a particular area, or a lot of temperature variation found in a particular part of area, because maybe because there is too much of industry, so pollution is extra, or maybe because of too much of greenery, parks are there, gardens are there, so this will cause slight change in the climate of a particular part of an area, that is called as microclimate. Similarly, we have microhabitats also, an area where you will have a smaller place for habitat means the area where living organism survives. So a microclimate is possible in a microhabitat basically. Now, in the same manner, we have the four climatic zones. In your geography, you have already covered these things in details.